Increasing in your scale, shahadatain, la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Increasing that. And always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his forgiveness. Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. All the time. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you're not making sin. All the time say, astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. Also brothers, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admit all of us to his jannah without any accountability. Say ameen. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-jannah wa ma qarrab ilayha min qawlin wa amal. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or seek refuge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the hellfire. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah wa a'udhu bika min al-nar. Ask Allah that all the time, brothers, in these days. Brothers, Ramadan, what did we learn in Ramadan? Madrasa of Ramadan. Ramadan about to leave us. We learn in Ramadan salah, how to stand and make qiyam. We learn in the month of Ramadan al-thabat, to be steadfast in your deen, to be firm in your deen in Ramadan and after Ramadan inshaAllah Rabbil Alameen. We learn in Ramadan to close that gap between our action and our ibadah. Because subhanAllah, sometimes we are very, very good nasik, very good mu'min in the masjid. But when we step out the masjid, we are a different person. No, we learn in Ramadan to be a mu'min, a good Muslim, inside the masjid and outside the masjid. We learn in Ramadan this month how to have good manners and good akhlaq and good conduct with Muslim and non-Muslim. With Muslim and non-Muslim. I can say with non-Muslim first and with Muslim after that. Because you are the one who's carrying, you are the ambassador of Islam here in this country. You are the one who's carrying the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have to give good impression about your deen, about your Islam. That's why we learn al-akhlaq in the month of Ramadan, brothers. Also, brothers, Ramadan, when you pray in Ramadan, this is for yourself, brothers. But again, we have to show others and Allah first that good akhlaq and good manners. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَخْشَ اللَّهَ وَيَتَّقِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. Taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers, in Ramadan. We have to come from the stage of الصيام to another stage which is higher than that, الصوم. We said that before. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. But we are not looking for the level of siyam. Siyam just from food and drink. But when we're looking for the level of sawm, إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَانِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيَّ. Sawm is different from siyam. Sawm, Maryam, when she said, I will not talk to anybody today. نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَانِ صَوْمًا. She did not say siyam. Sawm, this is what we have to do all the year. Don't backbite, don't slander anybody, don't use bad words. Don't abuse or insult anybody. You have to be a good Muslim. This is what we learn in the Siyam to get the level of Sawm. Ayyuha al-ikhwatu al-ahbab. We learn in Ramadan, al-du'a, al-qiyam, Quran, generosity. Brothers, al-sabat ala al-ta'a. Al-thabat ala al-ta'a. Very important to think about that. This is what we learn in Ramadan, ayyuha al-ikhwatu al-ahbab. Keep doing that all the year, not just in the month of Ramadan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever or whosoever fast the 30 days of Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, and followed with 6 days of Shawwal, كَأَنَّمَا صَامَ الدَّهْرِ. We fast 30 days time 10, 300, and 60 days in Shawwal time 10, gonna be 60, then 360, like as if you fast all the year. To follow the month of Ramadan with 60 days of Shawwal. You can fast these days during the month of Shawwal, all the month, no problem, any time in the month. Brothers, Laylatul Qadr insha'Allah. And we need you to come to the masjid after Ramadan. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثًا. The one that will shiver of Ramadan, the one who used to come for Qiyam every day, coming after Ramadan, that person like that lady, she was sewing a beautiful cloth, working hard for that. And she make it very beautiful dress. And suddenly she get her scissor and she cut it and she trash it. That one, he used to come in Ramadan, and after Ramadan he stopped coming to the masjid. After Ramadan he stopped fast. After Ramadan he stopped making good deeds. He became a different person. Like that lady. sewing that beautiful dress, and she cut it and trashed it just like that. Oh, Allah, it's bad. Subhanallah. That's why Allah said that. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةِ الْأَنْكَاثِ. After that strong iman and taqwa Allah, you throw it, you trash it like that, easy. No, brothers. We have to really and think about that, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. The last thing, inshallah, with me today, which is very important, we have to cover it. It's a very important topic. Brothers, your zakah. It's very important. Your zakah. Some brothers, they are very heedless about that. Even if they have money, they said, they put their hand in their pocket blindly, oh, take this, khalas. Yeah. No, it's not khalas. No, no. It's وَفِي أَمْوَلَيْهِمْ حَقٌ مَعْلُومٌ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. That's haqq. It's the right of Allah. The right of the masakeen. And ma'loom. Ma'loom. Allah measure it. Evaluate it. 2.5%. This is just for the cash or the if you have business or whatever. But there are too many types of zakawat or zakah, zakat al-rikaz, anything is coming under the ground, 25%, you have to give zakat the gold, the silver, the cash money, the trade business, and zakat al-zuru', the cattle, the animals. There are too many things. It is not just that you show some cash in your bank and say, this is my zakah. No. You have to measure it, 2.5%, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that zakah should go to the 8 types of people. إنما الصدقات للفقراء, the faqir, the one who is in need, والمساكين. Actually for me, come forward the brothers, we still have some spots here, and the brothers, they're standing in the back. Please, please come forward inshallah. Fill these gaps. Fill these gaps inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. Come on brothers, I will not talk until I finish. You'll come on please. Come on. وإذا قيل لكم تفسحوا في المجالس. Come on brothers from the back. Come on here. We have a lot of spots here. Your brothers are standing in the back and you have too many spots here. You have to cover this. You have to fill these gaps inshallah. Come on brothers from the back. Come on. We have two types of faqir. We have al-faqir and al-miskin. الفقير, that faqir, he can come behind the, outside the masjid and he can open his hand, brother, give me. He have no shame to come openly and say, give me, this is my right. But the miskeen could be me and you. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in the Quran. يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُّفُ تَعْرِفُهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ لَا يَسْأَلُونَ النَّاسَ إِلْحَافِ. That miskeen could be somebody like me and you. He has honor. He has position even in the community. But he has too many kids and too many responsibilities, and his money is not enough for him. Look for these people. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ الْمِسْكِينَ الَّذِي تَرُدُّهُ اللُّقْمَةَ وَاللُّقْمَةَانَ وَلَا الْتَمْرَ وَلَا الْتَمْرَتَانَ وَلَكِنَّ الْمِسْكِينَ الَّذِي لَا يَسْأَلِ النَّاسَ إِلْحَافِ. That miskin, he is the one who is not going to big people for money and to ask him because he has some kind of dignity and shyness. Look for these people. That's why Allah said, إِنَّمَا الصَّدَقَةُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْعَامِلِينَ عَلَيْهَا. Number 3. والمؤلفة قلوبهم. And we have too many مؤلفة قلوبهم in this country. Too many people, they came just new Muslims. Sometimes they are poor, they need some help. You can give them from the zakah too, to make them happy. وفي الرقاب والغارمين. If somebody is owing somebody money or in debt, you can help him from the zakah also. وفي سبيل الله. Let's stop here in سبيل الله. I'm telling you the knowledge of Islam. This is what the scholar said, it's not me. وفي سبيل الله. في سبيل الله, some scholars say the jihad. طيب. الحمد لله, we don't have jihad now. I'm sorry يعني to say that. Okay. Don't have jihad now. But our jihad, the meaning of jihad, the word jihad also, it is not qital. Because qital in Arabic different from jihad. In this country, most of this American society, when they invite us to talk, they're asking me these questions. What do you know about jihad? And they say jihad. Jihad is not a bad word. It's a beautiful word. Jihad means striving. Striving. When you be a good Muslim against your shaitan, you are making jihad. When you are feeding your kids from halal money, halal food, this is jihad. When you learn your deen and your Islam in the right way, this is jihad. Striving. But the word qital means fighting, killing. This is the qital, different word completely. I love this word jihad. Jihad is a beautiful word. You know? To be a good Muslim, to strive in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be a good person, you know? This is jihad. When you're stuck in the 405, going to your work for 4 hours in the traffic, this is big jihad. You know, there's this big jihad, you know, subhanallah. Also, fi sabilillah, your zakah, you can give part of it to the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, special in this Western society. We don't have the Islamic government here to spend for the masajid. We don't have Islamic government here to give sadaqat, or somebody can take care of the masjid, like Wazarat al-Awqaf, you know, we don't have that. The scholar, they said, part of your zakah, you can give it to the masjid. Dur al-Qur'an al-Kareem, to teach the Qur'an. Part of your zakah. Everything, it's fi sabilillah. It's fi sabilillah, in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That masjid waqf lil-Muslimin. Al-waqf lil-Muslimin, you have to take care of this waqf. You know, you have to spend it from your money to support that. Do you want to come one day, you will see no electricity, no power, no water, Allah forbid, in the masjid? Of course, we're not looking for that. That's why part of your zakah to give this the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ Ibn al-Sabil, the wayfarer. If that, even that person rich in his country, maybe close to his money, his wealth, or his wallet, you can give him from zakah too. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is faridah. Faridatan min Allah. It's a faridah, obligatory. This zakah, it is not your choice. That's why anybody's giving zakah, I cannot call him, he's a kareem, he's a generous person. Yes, because this is haqq Allah, the haqq of the masakeen, you know. But the one is giving extra nafaqah, charity, is giving extra, plus zakah, that person, you can call him kareem. And the kareem person also, not the one you is waiting for people to beg him. No, the one, if he recognizes his brother in Islam, he is in need, himself he will give. Like Abu Bakr and Umar and Abdul Rahman ibn Auf, Uthman ibn Affan, too many Sahaba, Ka'b ibn Malik, mashallah, too many Sahaba, they were so kareem. This is zakah. Number two, another type of sadaqah or tatawwa. Sadaqat al-tatawwa. This is the voluntarily charity or sadaqah. This is different from zakah. Zakah, we said fard. You have to do it. Sadaqat al-tatawwa could be money, could be food, could be clothes. You can do it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حتى تنفقوا مما تحبون. I noticed that in the masajid, subhanallah, if you don't need your clothes, all the clothes, you go to your closet, your wife is putting in the bag, just trash it in the masjid. Masjid is going to take your trash. You know, masjid is not a trash can to get your old clothes and you throw it to the masjid. I see it in the receipt in my masjid there. And subhanallah, they fill the garage with a lot of clothes like this. What is this? Go to Salvation Army or wherever, go give this clothes to them. Why you bring it to the masjid? Masjid is not a trash. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرِّ. You'll never get the birr, the piety. You'll never get the jannah, the righteousness, until you spend from which is you love. مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar, he used to love fish so much, and grapes so much. And he was waiting to eat this, and he see miskin, he used to, what, subhanAllah, before he put it in his mouth, he used to give it to him. They said, Ya Abdullah, we've been looking for fish 3-4 days to give it to you because you love it. And you give that fish to the miskin. He said, yes, because I love it, I give it to him. Mimma tuhibbun, the thing you love it, you like it, just give. This is the way, this is Islam. I love this, but for the sake of Allah, for the sake of Allah. I love this word, for the sake of Allah, I will give, inshaAllah. This is the way. Also, brothers, sadaqat al-tatawwa, this voluntarily, and zakat al-fitr, or sadaqat al-fitr. This is zakat al-fitr, or sadaqat al-fitr, this is fard also, obligatory. $10, they said, for each and every person, male and female, young or old. Even if you have a new baby born today, you have to give $10 for him. Sadaqat al-fitr. This is why, to purify your fasting. Your fasting will be hanging like this. Allah will not receive it until you give this sadaqah and zakah. Even if you are poor, yes, give it. Go get money from somebody and give it. Because somebody is going to give you. Islam is like this. Somebody poor will give him, and he's giving to others also. This is a way. This is Islam. This is a Muslim society. This is very important. You have to give this zakah or this fitr sadaqah before the sun rises in the day of Eid. Why you have to wait for that? In 15th of Ramadan, you have to give this before 15th. To be in the hand of the poor and the needy before Eid to make them happy, inshaAllah. We talk about zakah. We talk about the voluntary sadaqah. We talk about sadaqat al-fitr. And also, fidyat al-iftar. Fidyat al-iftar, this money or this to feed a miskin every day for the one who was not able to fast in Ramadan. Maybe he's sick or very old, lady or man or male or female. You know, somebody's not able to fast. You have to feed one miskin every day. Every day, say $10 also for feeding one miskin every day, $300 for all month or whatever days you did not fast, you have to, inshallah, if you are not able. If you're able, you can, if you break one day or you did not fast one day, you can make it after Ramadan. But this is the fidyat al-iftar. Also, brothers, the benefits of sadaqah and the fruits of the sadaqah for the Muslims who will be, inshallah, get the benefit of that sadaqah in his life before his death and even in the hereafter, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Sadaqah tadfa'u al-bala' tadfa'u mitat al-su' As-sadaqah tutfi'u ghadab al-rabb. That any kind of evil or the bad way of death, wal'azu billah, accident or something like that. Or sadaqah distinguish and stop the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your sadaqah. As-sadaqah tasuddu 70 baban min as-su' wal'azu billah. Sadaqah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take 70 types of evil and bad thing from you. Because of sadaqah. With your sadaqah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe out your sin. Tuhadhib al-akhlaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you good manners and good akhlaq. As-sadaqah, it's a growth of money. Tazidu al-mal. Khudh min amwalihim sadaqatan. Tuzakkihim wa tutahiruhum biha. Tutahiruhum wa tuzakkihim biha. Tutahiruhum wa tuzakkihim biha. Wa salli alayhim inna salataka sakarun lahum. Take, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, part of their money to purify their money and their wealth and their themselves with this sadaqah. في الآخرة الصدقة تطفئ حر القبور. Subhanallah, the fire in the grave. The sadaqah will stop that. And the believer, like you inshallah, will be under the shade of his sadaqah in the day of judgment. While no shade except the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And seven types of Muslim will be under the shade of Allah. One of them, a man who's giving sadaqah with his right hand, he hides it from his left hand. As-sadaqah المتصدقون تحت عرش الرحمن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will receive that sadaqah from you, charity. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise it for you, like if somebody has a falu. كما يربي أحدكم فلوه. Falu is small horse. If you have a small horse, you're feeding that horse, taking care of that horse. MashaAllah, growing up, your sadaqah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take it and receive it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise it for you. And in the day of judgment, you will see it as if like the Mount of Uhud, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Brothers, please be good after Ramadan. Keep and guard your salah after Ramadan. Keep read the Quran after Ramadan. Come to the masjid after Ramadan. Fast 6 days of Shawwal. Be a good Muslim. Always make dua for your ummah, for your Muslim ummah. You see the news every day. You don't want me to say anything about what is going on around the Muslim ummah. Subhanallah. See that airplane in Algeria last night crashed, and this subhanAllah, people dying like that. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guard your ummah, to protect your Muslim ummah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give peace to the Muslim and non-Muslim people, to bring peace to this earth, أيها الإخوة الأحباب. وأزلفت الجنة للمتقين غير بعيد هذا ما توعدون لكل أواب حفيظ. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم لابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوبون توبوا الى الله واستغفروه يغفر لكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبه للمتقين. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله ولي المؤمنين واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers, inshallah, don't forget to pay your zakah, especially your masjid. I was here last night. MashaAllah, يعني your beautiful masjid and the beautiful community. And Calvert City is beautiful because of you, because of this masjid, mashallah. We need you, inshallah, to give your zakah and your sadaqah. You can go to the brothers here in the masjid, inshallah, in their office, and you can give part of your zakah to the masjid, or you can put in the box, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. And they told me they have another fundraising for the masjid because they are targeting $240,000 at the expense of the masjid. And just the expense for the month of Ramadan, $60,000 just in this masjid. We need part of this money to cover all of this, inshallah. You are the one who can do that. They have educational program during the year. They have too many stuff, the tax, the property tax, and the maintenance, and too much stuff, the imams, mashallah, everything. Please, inshallah, you can go and ask them in the office, give part of your zakah, and tomorrow, inshallah, be ready for that also. They're going to have fundraising after Salat, before the dua, inshallah, they have Khatm al-Quran. I think it's 29th, inshallah, 29th. Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. They have Khatm al-Quran, bi-iznillah, Azza wa Jal. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات مؤمنين والمؤمنات أحياء منهم والأموات إنك يا ربي سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم تقبل صيامنا وصلاتنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ارحم المستضعفين من المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم احقن دماءهم آمن روعاتهم واغفر لهم ذنوبهم واحفظهم من بين أيديهم ومن خلفهم وعن أيمانهم وعن شمائلهم اجعلنا جميعا لك من الشاكرين اللهم اجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا وجلاء همومنا وأحزاننا يسر لنا أمورنا يمن لنا كتابنا وارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فإنك علينا قادر يا ودود يا ودود يا ودود يا ذا العرش المجيد اللهم إنا نسألك بنور وجهك الذي ملأ أركان عرشك نسألك بقدرتك التي قدرت بها على خلقك نسألك برحمتك التي وسعت كل شيء لا إله إلا أنت يا مغيث أغثنا يا مغيث أغثنا ارحمنا أكرمنا استرنا اجبرنا اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا أرحم الراحمين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى ينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيموا ترصوا استردوا الله في الدجابس ترصوا واعتدلوا الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول رب لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون
الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers. Just a couple of reminders. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Syed Jumah, for the great khutbah.